1,200 meters down, the sunlight is gone, and the pressure is crushing. A world where red light cannot reach, and ordinary bodies would collapse in seconds. Here, the dragonfish beams an invisible searchlight, hunting with chemistry no surface creature needs. The deeper you go, the more nature abandons the familiar rules of life. What could force evolution to shape animals so alien? And just how far does this transformation go? At 1,200 meters, the rules of physics clamp down with relentless force. Every 10 meters adds another atmosphere of pressure. So by this depth, the weight above is 100 times greater than at the surface. Bones would snap, lungs would flatten, and any pocket of air would be squeezed to nothing. Sunlight fades fast in water. Red wavelengths disappear first, gone by the time you reach 100 meters. Blue lingers the longest, but even that is swallowed by the black below 1,000 meters. Pressure and darkness shape every living thing here. In this total darkness, the dragonfish glides, armed with a weapon almost no one else can see, a beam of red bioluminescence. Most deep-sea eyes are blind to red, making the dragonfish's headlamp a private searchlight. It scans for prey, invisible in the gloom, hunting with a chemistry that rewrites the rules of vision. Where light cannot reach, life finds ways to make its own. Bioluminescence turns the ocean into a private theater of flashes and lures, a secret language in the crushing dark. Light in these depths is an invention of survival. Firefly squid drift through the water, their bodies dotted with photophores, tiny organs that spark with living blue light. Each flash is powered by a chemical reaction. Luciferin meets luciferase, releasing a cold glow that never wastes energy as heat. This bioluminescence is not just a spectacle, it is a shield. The firefly squid's belly lights match the faint shimmer from above, erasing its silhouette from hunters lurking below. Glass squid take a different path. Their bodies are nearly see-through, a living transparency. Organs float like faint shadows inside a pale, jelly dome, making the animal almost invisible from every angle. Some creatures even combine both tricks, ghostly transparency and bursts of light, blending perfectly with the endless night, hiding from danger and ambushing prey in a world where darkness is absolute. Big fin squid drift through the blackness, their arms and tentacles stretched into ribbons, each connected by delicate sheets of webbing. These creatures seem to float rather than swim, held aloft by bodies made almost entirely of GEL. At these depths, hard skeletons and gas-filled swim bladders would collapse under the weight of the ocean. Instead, big fin squid and their kin have replaced rigid forms with soft, incompressible tissue. Their bodies are so watery and light that they barely weigh more than the seawater around them. Below 1,000 meters, most deep-sea animals abandon air for fat and jelly, because lipids provide lift that pressure cannot crush. The giant squid, stretching up to 13 meters, follows the same rule. Its massive form glides with the help of buoyant flesh, conserving energy in a world where every meal is uncertain. Here, softness is strength, and the secret to surviving the abyss is to become part of it. Fang-toothed fish drift through the deep, their jaws hinged wide, lined with fangs so long they cannot close their mouths. In a world where food is rare, these teeth are insurance, and anything that fits is swallowed whole, no matter how large or how spiny. Their eyes are small and nearly useless, but the jaws never miss. Nearby, another master of concealment waits. Ultra-black fish discovered by researchers in 2020 have skin that traps 99.95% of incoming light. Under even the strongest submersible beams, these fish vanish into the black, their outlines erased by microscopic structures that scatter photons until almost none escape. This is more than camouflage. It is near-perfect invisibility, rivaling the blackest synthetic fabrics ever made. In these depths, every creature is either a hunter with a mouth built for ambush, or a shadow so absolute that even light itself cannot betray its presence. Food is so rare in the Abyss that survival depends on patience and opportunism. Every day, a gentle snow of organic particles, dead plankton, fish scales, fragments of jelly, drifts down from above. This is marine snow, and for most creatures here, it is the only meal they will ever know. When a larger carcass falls, the plane erupts into motion. Swarms of amphipods, some no bigger than a grain of rice, descend in a frenzy, stripping flesh within hours. Among them move giant isopods, armored and pale, reaching half a meter in length. These deep scavengers can go months without food, their slow metabolism an answer to constant scarcity. In the deep, giants are born not from plenty, but from the struggle to store energy and outlast famine. Every adaptation, from tiny amphipod to lumbering isopod, is shaped by the economics of hunger and the rare windfall of a feast. Snailfish drift above the silty trench floor, their bodies soft as pudding, thriving where pressure would crush almost any other vertebrate. Their very existence is a study in survival. At depths pushing 8,200 meters, these fish carry a secret weapon, TMAO, a tiny molecule that shields their proteins from being warped by the crushing force outside. This chemical defense is a literal secret against the deep. Each 1,000 meters deeper, their muscle tissue packs in another 50 millimoles of TMAO, reaching nearly 400 millimoles per kilogram, the highest concentration measured in any vertebrate. That concentration is the highest scientists have ever recorded. But this adaptation comes at a cost. Above that threshold, TMAO chemistry starts to work against life, setting a hard boundary for bony fish. Beyond that line, only invertebrates like amphipods endure. The deep draws a clear cost line between vertebrate and invertebrate life. In the cold polar waters, Antarctic sea spiders grow to the size of dinner plates, not because of pressure, but because oxygen-rich currents and icy temperatures slow their metabolism and let them become giant. Meanwhile, in the genetic shadows, some deep sea squid and octopuses turn to an emerging trick, adenosine to inosine RNA editing. Like a molecular spell check, this process tweaks messenger RNA after it is copied from DNA, allowing proteins to be fine-tuned for deep, cold, and dark. This form of editing rewrites the rules of adaptation. Scientists are still unraveling whether this molecular spell check is a true passport to the abyss, or just one more experiment in evolution's cosmic workshop. The mystery of the abyss remains wide open. As chemistry and genetics reach their limits, the question lingers: what forms of life, if any, could survive even deeper in realms we have yet to see? How much deeper can life go? Right now, over 80% of our ocean remains unexplored. Each new descent could reveal life stranger than fiction. The true face of Earth's depths is still hidden and waiting to be found.